today the system got converted from 408A to 448A. So we're going to be checking out the superheats, adjusting them if needed, and making sure everything's good. So, superheat day today. And you got my superheat crew right here. These are the tools that I use to adjust superheats. My first one, Fluke 52. Check out his rap sheet. My Fluke pipe clamp, you're going to need a couple of those when you're doing multiple cases. My little chingadera I use to adjust the TXVs on the stand on the bottom. Small, and it fits in my wallet. And my little shorty, a $15 gauge with a ball valve hose in the bottom, so I wouldn't have to carry my whole manifold set. And together, these guys,
by your powers combined, I am
Captain Superheat. So you want to put your pipe clamp closest to the sensing bulb of the power head for the TXV. So as close as you can there. And your suction pressure, grab it from wherever. It's usually right there, a couple inches away. So how do you determine the superheat? First, you take the temp from the suction line closest to the power head sensing bulb. Number two, the suction pressure, but you convert it using your PT chart. And you get the difference between those two. That's your superheat. Now subtraction, the difference of them. Check out this ice cream, nice and soft. I don't think the dry ice helped out on the conversion. So right now the case is at 1 degree, so it's been running for a while. Right now my clamp's on, 3.3 so far. Gauge on, we're about 15 pounds, so I'm going to close the door and see what I can get the readings after 10 minutes. So still 1 degree the case, and my pipe clamp is 4.6, it's been like that for a little bit, and my pressure stayed at 15 pounds. So again, my pressure converted is around minus 11 SST, and my pipe clamp is 4.6, so I'm just going to round up to 5. So you make the difference between those two is 16, that's my superheat. So now subtraction, where it's minus 6, no, it's a difference. And a good superheat is between 8 to 12, that's usually what you're looking for. So I'm going to open it up and adjust it. So here I'm just going to pause it for a little bit. I wanted to show it from my point of view and then the actual schematic inside of the TXV. So when I'm adjusting that stem clockwise, I'm actually pushing all the guts in and I'm pinching the valve. So I'm going to raise the superheat. When I'm going counterclockwise, I'm opening the valve, so it's stretching it out, I'm allowing more flow. So just because you open it up every time doesn't mean your case is going to get colder. That's not the answer to everything. You got to check out everything. Don't just open up the valve and think that's going to adjust your temp problems. So they always told me do a quarter at a time and wait 15 minutes for the adjustment. But
some men just want to watch the world burn.
And I've been doing it for a while, so I'm going to do a full turn. Because I got a lot of cases. And you know what?
Ain't nobody got time for that.
But seriously, I've been doing it for a long time, so I know these cases, I know my valves, so opening this one while full turn is not going to hurt me too bad. You don't want to open it too much, because then you're going to be flooding back the machines, the compressors, and you're going to get yourself in trouble. So right now, still, I think it was 16 pounds. My suction temp on my clamp's dropping slowly. So here we are, 16 pounds, so that's going to change my pressure, converted. And it already reached minus 4 once, so I want to make sure that swing, the low swing, it does it again. That's the number I'm going to grab, my low swing. And yeah, so right now, we're going to do minus 10 converted with my minus 4. So the difference between those two is going to be 6. So 6 is my superheat here. So I know I said 8 to 12 is good, but I'm going to show you why in a little bit. I'm okay with 6. I'm going to leave it at 6. I'm okay with 6. because the machine, the superheat going to the compressor is really high. So if I can cool it down with this one and some other ones, then I'm going to go ahead and do that. The newer cases that are being out there, they're being more efficient. So I know even some of the Walmart cases, they said the superheat should be 2 or 4, which is insane to me, but that's what they recommend on the new stuff. And you also want to check for flood back coming back when you adjust the superheat. So I'm making sure it's not too frosty, coming back too hard. I wanted to go back a little bit frosty right now because of my situation with the compressor, but you may want to make sure you're not flooding it back real bad. And of course, check your dryer that it's not plugged in before you do this. So this system is a single system, it's not part of the rack. As you can see right there, it was 408A, now it's 448, so we gotta change that sticker, cross it out. So to take the superheat on this one, same thing, pressure converted, 12 pounds, so that's minus 16, converted. And my suction temp is at 60 degrees, so my superheat for my compressor is 76. That's just insane. That's way too high. So that's why I was okay with the 6 superheat on it. I don't want to go too bad on it, but it's really high. The compressor superheat should be around 20, 25, 30, 35, but 76, that's way too hot. So my case is at minus 1 degrees, which is not good for ice cream. Ice cream runs at minus 6, minus 8, but this is what's frozen food, but they want to put ice cream in there. Okay. Here's my little tools right here. It's a different type, the sporting valve. You can pick those up anywhere, United, RSD. They pretty much give them to you if you buy enough stuff. And if you liked the video, subscribe, leave a like, and thank you so much for watching.
That's life. That's life. That's what all the people say.